This episode of Ask Jay is brought to you by HostGator. Coming up, do you bring in the pros for graphics? I'm Jay Adelson, and I'm the founder and chairman of Revision 3. I've started and built a number of companies. My goal in this show is to pass on some of the knowledge from my experiences to you, the budding entrepreneurs, and hopefully leave you with some words of wisdom. So today's question comes from Bill with a video question.
Hi Jay, my name is Bill Jones, and I was wondering, is it necessary to hire someone to do a website for you or a logo?
Bill, you're asking a question that sometimes I hesitate to answer because I know there's some amazing website builders out there. There's some great tools to kind of drag and drop your way through developing your website. But I gotta tell you, my personal experience here is nothing beats a professional when you're dealing with graphics and presentation. And there's a lot of reasons why. First off, time. If you're not good at graphics and web design and building websites, even if you're a little bit technical and you can navigate these tools, it's gonna take you sometimes as much as 10 times longer to create the same output than somebody's a pro. And you wanna get to that business operating as fast as possible so you can get the jump on the competition and start recruiting your people. So a pro is great for that. Another piece to this is user interface and the whole graphic user interface expertise. It's not simple stuff. It's not like you're born with this knowledge of, you know, how to design a web page or an app to optimize on that user experience. And you'll hear these terms tossed around these days where there are folks focused exclusively on UX or UI. And there's a reason, because it's become a real art and a science. And so having somebody with experience building a site for ease of use will make a big difference. I know that in the case of Digg, when we moved from a mostly textual website to Digg version 2, which had those yellow buttons and were really interactive and beautiful, it was a huge, huge uplift to usage and consumability of the site. So bringing in a pro who understands that stuff is fantastic. You also asked about a logo. And I'll tell you, while I do think bringing in an artist to design a logo is valuable, I don't think it's necessarily your top priority as a business. You can always redo your logo later. However, once you do, I'd recommend considering these collaborative systems. I know that there's a big debate. Jeffrey Kalmakoff, who was one of the lead designers at Digg, definitely had an attitude about the commoditization of design, and these collaborative systems might be a bad thing for designers. But if you're a startup professional and you're looking to get something done initially, consider free as an option. And, you know, 99 designs and services like that certainly get you closer and closer to that. Getting a professional definitely will make a much more interesting logo. Revision 3's logo and Digg's logo, in both those cases, we actually paid to have those logos created by professionals, folks like Daniel Burka and others out there. And I think it really did make a difference in terms of our brand's impression and the professionalism going forward. So in a minute, maybe some thoughts on where to find these folks, but first, let's thank our sponsors. This episode of Ask Jay is brought to you by HostGator. Looking for a place to launch or blog a website? Frustrated with customer support at your current hosting provider? Go with HostGator and get up and running in minutes. With plans starting at just $3.96 a month, you get top-rated 24/7 customer support, access to tools, including a website builder with over 4,000 templates. HostGator will even migrate your current site for free. Can you believe servers are 130% powered by wind energy? That's about as green as it gets. Unlimited disk space, unlimited bandwidth, a 45-day money-back guarantee, and a $100 Google AdWords credit to market your website. And right now, for Revision 3 viewers, HostGator is offering 25% off your order or your first month free. Go to www.hostgator.com and enter the code JAdelson at checkout to get your discount. Okay, where to find a pro to do this? You can find them in a lot of places. I know that the number one thing I would recommend is find the sites that you love. Websites that you frequent a lot, and look to see where they were designed. If they're big websites like, you know, Facebook or Digg, they often have internal designers at this point. But sometimes if you do a little research, you can find out who designed their first version and go take a look at it. Use the Wayback Machine. Find out what these sites look like at the beginning. But other startups that you're really into, definitely check out who's been designing that and consider going that route. Another route are these collaborative systems like 99 Designs and others, where basically you put up a scope of work and a bunch of people compete and you choose one. It's a fantastic a way to get started, although again, there's a little bit, if you're a designer, there are some questions just about whether or not that's good for the design world in general. But definitely a consideration. And then of course, just like coding, you could definitely outsource using things like Elance or Odesk or other services like that, where you're basically posting something for people to respond to. And then of course, the challenge with that is just coming up with rates and figuring out how you wanna move forward. This is fun. Thanks for joining us today at AskJay. Send us email questions to askjay@revision3.com. I would love to see lots of interaction on the various social media sites. Twitter, @JayAdelson. Want to see conversation about these topics. Want to hear what you think about these episodes, but also any questions. Feel free to submit them via Twitter. Also, the AskJayAdelson channel on YouTube. We love to see video responses there. And please share these videos with other people. If you think this is helping you, please definitely share it. Post it to Facebook. Do whatever you need to do to bring us more entrepreneurs, because we really value their input in this process. We also have a Facebook page, facebook.com/AskJayAdelson. We'd love to see you there as well. So anyway, thanks for joining us, and until next time.